Well, hello YouTubers, welcome back. Another episode of Mod Source 2. Let's get started. So, welcome back. I've not done a huge amount this time around, except for something up there. I've put in a slight temporary second floor, well, first floor even. Basically, I've been working on apple milk and tea. And boy, oh boy. Is this taking some work? You can't believe it. It's been a real sort of chicken and egg story, this. But basically, so I started off by making the food processor here to realise that charcoal doesn't work. And we're going to get shot by that guy, aren't we? Okay. It's always the way. Let's go and take him out then. Anyway, so it's been like a real chicken and egg sort of thing. So the food processor didn't work with charcoal as I was hoping, and then I thought I'd make the tea maker or whatever as well. That has no right-click interface, and the wiki is really handy because it's in Japanese. So anyway, so after watching a couple of supposedly sort of, I don't know, intro to apple milk and tea videos on YouTube, they didn't actually show how to craft anything at all, and basically all they did is just show all the various items in the mod, which quite frankly is a lot. There is a heck of a lot. So if I go to apples, so basically all of this stuff, all these cups and, you know, I don't know, you can make all these cardboard boxes. The food's pretty impressive. These apple tarts and stuff, I mean, just, so there's two pages of food, basically, that you can sort of make, and drinks and stuff. Each of the different sort of drinks has sort of a potion effect. So if you look at this one here, this has got night vision and regeneration, immunization, you know, soda water gives you speed, etc, etc, etc. You know, it's pretty extensive. All of the food items, so the mushroom stews and stuff like this, basically when you throw them on the floor, they don't initially sort of stick to the floor, so you could push them around a little bit if you wanted to organize things or whatever. Looks pretty cool, stuff like that. The other thing I tried is, like I say, I made some of these Bibliocraft tables, but unfortunately, when you place stuff on a table, so if I put this sword down, it basically, if I put these food processors on the table, it basically turns into like that. It turns into a separate item. It's basically like an item frame or something. It doesn't actually, the machine isn't usable basically when you put it on the table, which I found really annoying because that would look really cool. So I just put them on wooden blocks for now. But anyway, so like I say, so this thing won't accept charcoal. So what I have found is that there's a type of battery that he uses. Anyway, so I've actually made the battery. Here we go, here's one, this chargeable battery. And once again, the battery charger itself doesn't take charcoal. So, although if you look at the tooltip there at the top, it looks like it does take RF. So once again, I'm going to have to make something else. So I'm going to quickly make an engine to put some power into this thing, to put some power in the cell to power the food processor so I can finally make some tea. So yeah, like I say, I was playing for about an hour just getting this far, really. Anyway, so let's quickly make an engine. I think I've got all the stuff to do that now. So back in a second. Okay, so one survivalist generator, hopefully this will power it up. Let's have a little look. Getting any charge? But yes, we are getting some charge. Amazing. Well, it's Not the neatest of builds, but at least it works. So let's get a little. Well, hopefully that might be enough. Let's see if we can actually get some charge in here. Okay, it's getting some charge, good stuff. And we've got some green tea leaves. Woohoo! Now, I haven't actually used this thing yet, but I think you just right click on there. There we go. So that's got green tea in it now, at least, hopefully. So let's just use our cup on that. Yes, hey presto, we've got green tea, which gives us some haste. Awesome. So, it's not that we're fast enough already. Anyway, let's pop the battery back in the battery charger. And there we go. Oh, actually, we can. If you put green tea through a crafting table, you can make just normal tea. So, if you want to make normal tea, oh, we can't use this. Okay. Maybe we gotta empty it of tea. Let's try. As I say, information on this mod is sparse to say the least. So let's see how many cups we get. Oh, there it goes. So let's do some normal tea. Does that give me a buff? No. Oh well. As you can see, when it's dropped on the floor there, it's sort of being pushed around a little bit. Oh, it just says instant health. Okay, well, I guess that's like a healing potion then. But anyway, there's something, so pretty awesome. what I do to just have a bit of tea. Anyway, so let's I was thinking maybe carrying on with a bit more Britannia today. There's a few things we can make. Pop down some more charcoal into these things. Let's do half each. Oh, I've found that if you just stick a whole stack of items in the dropper, it still will only drop one at a time. They're going to drop for us. This potion effect's getting really annoying. Drop already. Do stuff. There we go. Anyway, so if you look now, there's only 8 left, and cool. So that'll charge that up. Anyway, so on the front of these mana spreaders, you can basically attach a beam. I don't know if I can use it to show it. No. Okay. Well, yeah, I'd really want to use one as fuel. Anyway, so I think they're called focuses. Oops. Focus, yep, here we go. So there's quite a few of these lens sort of focuses. Yeah, this looks a bit more like it. Here we go. So basically, you can adjust the particle beam that's coming out with the various lenses. And one I was thinking of doing is basically there's one that sort of breaks. I don't know if it's resistance, but there's one that you can bounce them. Have it affect by gravity. Here we go, it's the lens bore. Now basically what this does, this allows the mana beam to actually hit things as opposed to sort of just pass through them. Well, I mean they will hit things but they won't do any damage to them. This basically turns it into like a drill. So we're going to need a rune of greed and a mana lens. Oh dear, the rune of greed. That's pretty expensive. Oh well, maybe we're not going to do this episode. I did actually go mining, and I did find another couple of diamonds. So I guess we're going with plan B for this episode then, which is go to the Nether. So one thing I did find is that I didn't notice this, but my pickaxe upgraded itself. Well, anyway, it got a diamond durability or something on it. And basically, if you look as I'm hovering over it, it now says it can mine obsidian. So I went and mined some obsidian. So I guess we'll probably didn't get enough, but anyway, I guess we'll go and sort of stick it over there in that area behind the house over there. Help from a little creeper there. Okay, thank you, Mr. Creeper. I didn't really want that, but anyway, at least I didn't damage anything. I guess this is probably, I shouldn't be doing this at night. Oops, here comes a zombie. And something behind me, and great. Well, I guess I was sleeping after all then. Come on, Mr. Zombie, you know you want to jump in here, really. Come on, if I can get up here, you can get up here, Mr. Zombie. That's right, in you go. Go on, go in, jump in. Oh well, so much for cheesing him in the lava pit. Oh dear, come on then. Blimey. Ooh, that's interesting. What did he drop there? A common treasure. Thorncraft, indeed. Okay. What's a common treasure when it's at home? Okay. Yep, I definitely could hear another zombie. Wow, he almost got us. I see a spine zombie. Okay. Wow, these guys are hard. I need a machine gun. There is one in this mod pack. Well, that's a first. Try not to die next to a runic altar. All of your stuff will go into it. It's pretty funny. Okay. Oops. Pickaxe. That's not my pickaxe. Where's my pickaxe? Not got it yet. There we go. Wow, fun and games here. I've lost my chest armor. No! Poor old chest armor. Where's my chest armor gone? Oh well, I guess we'll be making some more chest armor then. Blimey, that's probably one of the hardest zombies I think I've ever fought. Gosh. Anyway, we'll put that on for now. We got another bauble. Uncommon treasure or something. Well, whatever. Anyway, well, I guess I better craft another couple of bits of armor. Let's stash all this and back in a second. Okay, what did I get this time? Well, got an emerald, splash potion of healing, really useful, and another gold coin. Okay, well, let's carry on stashing stuff and clear my inventory by me. So, for those of you that don't know, here's how you make Britannia armor. Basically, you just dump a load of iron ingots into the pool. And just use the normal crafting. So, that's how you make a chest. And I haven't quite got enough of a helmet. I'm just cooking up a bit more iron over there. But, back in a second. And there's the helmet as well. So, all sorted again. I did find my axe just lying around over here in this hole. I've just filled it. And just almost made the portal. But so a couple of units short. So I might whip downstairs and downstairs. Down to the big lava pool area down here and grab another couple of bits. So back in a second. Okay, wish me luck. Here goes nothing. I hate the nether. And wow. Okay. We're right on top of a dungeon. Gosh. Somebody's shooting at me. What the heck was that? Something's exploding. Okay, well, right then. Let's get some walls up. It's dodgy as heck. There's an interesting sort of thing over there. Looks like a chalice or something. I don't know. Maybe it's a tree. But it's still sort of loading. Anyway, I'm really concerned about ghast at the moment. And all sorts of other nasties. So, top priority is to build this up rather quickly. Yep, and right on cue there's a ghast. Okay, this is going to be even more fun. There's a ghast right outside. Oh my god, it's going to take my portal out. No. Okay. That wasn't him. Okay. Oh dear. This looks like fun. My portal's still going. What the heck's that? Don't mind me, I just live it. Let's try and keep my portal up. I think that's a bee's nest over there. Wow, we are. Come on. I'm gonna try not to fall off here. Let's come over here a little bit. Great, it's soul sand that's slowing me down. I'm gonna cower in fear over here for a second. Wow, there's two bees' nests together. Come on in. Die! No, you're not dying. What's up with that? Go on, there we go. I didn't see him drop anything, but he's a bit far away. Oh well. Let's hopefully finish this off in peace. Yeah, dodgy as heck. Okay. And I didn't fall off the world. Amazing. That's a long way down. Cool. Still got some left. So we'll stick a little sort of doorway here. I don't know. Hopefully that'll give us some defense. And, yeah. Well, in some ways I'm kind of glad I spawned on top of a dungeon. Because, means finding stuff's going to be that much easier. Because I want some, nether wart and other bits and pieces. So, wow, looks like there's a chest or something there as well. Might just cobble my way down. There's no my luck, I'll just fall to my death anyway. It sounded fairly ominous. I don't know what that was. I can hear like a... I don't know if you guys can make that out. Can you hear a skeleton? Somebody with a skeleton? Zombie pigman and a mini one, he's coming up. So I guess the stairs come up. No torches, okay. Probably not the best of time to run out. Well, I don't have any charcoal on me, so I'll just grab all of this quickly and we'll make a hasty retreat, I think. Because I don't really want to be hanging around this place. Let's grab a few more nether brick. Okay. Yeah, definitely kind of impressive. Oh, what is that? It's like a tower or something. Gosh. I've never seen one of those before. There's quite a few of them here. They look extraordinarily ominous, knowing this place. So, let's grab this chest here. Wow, well worth it. And we'll come back at another time, I think. Yep, I don't know what that noise is, but I'm not really sure I want to find out. And a wisp as well. Hopefully that'll stop me falling over there. Ah, there's some sort of ghoul or something just there. Lovely. Unfortunately, he hasn't got any range attacks. Anyway, not tempting fate. Let's just grab a load of netherrack because we're here and we can dig it super quick. Oops. Wow, that spreads fast. Blimey. That's the fastest spreading lava I've seen. Yep, I know. I'm tempting fate. That sounded pretty scary too. Probably not the best of places to be just wandering around. But anyway. Wow, I'd really, really like some glowstone. And some nether quartz. And pretty much everything. Oh, there's some up there. Let's go and see if I can wander up there. Oh dear, just aggro some pigmen. Hopefully they can't reach us. What was that? Something did explode. Okay. This is just nether quartz. I didn't think nether quartz exploded, but maybe it does now. I know there's, I think it was like a nether coal or something that exploded. But, what, only one piece? You're kidding me. I'd mine like three or four of these. That's, we need quite a few of those. So, well, actually, it's giving me the ore. Okay. Well, this seems as good a place as any to plant down this nether wart here. next to my other bits of farms and stuff. So, ender lilies are getting there. They are taking a long time to grow. Anyway, let's wander back inside. Oh, exploring another part two. Hopefully these guys still aren't aggro on me. We'll soon find out. It looks like he is. What a shame. Oh well, leave him to it. Actually, before I get too far away, I suppose I want to actually bind this place. Always a good idea. Let's set a waypoint here. Yep, they don't like me mining this stuff. What's this? Plutonium. Okay. Don't think I've seen that before. Well, those guys aren't around here, and while they're not, I'm gonna swipe as much ore as I can. Glowing over there. Don't know if I quite want to go down there just yet. Can't make it out. Anyway, let's try and get some glowstone. Yep, that looks about right. Try not to dig my way too far down. The gold was handy. Can always use. Good grief. These floating ores get a bit annoying. What on earth is that? Oh, it's one of those little hellfish, yeah. Okay, and he dropped an emerald fragment. Anyway, I think I'll, oh, I didn't take any damage, okay. I was going to drink the tea, see what it did. Anyway, let's pop some in here, because I'm getting pretty full. Well, I think we got different, the music as well, kind of peaceful here. Well, it's far from peaceful. But, yep, that's why. They're the ferrous, oh man. Yep, I do want this stuff. Ferrous has been incredibly hard to come by. Couple of elementals over there. Let's go and eat some food and we'll take them on, I think. Got a wither skeleton as well. Cool, he dropped a bone. These zombies still after me. Apparently so. Oh well. And we got a blaze on. Time to definitely get out of here. I think it was this way. It is. Good. Well. Got so many items from the nether. I think I'm gonna stash them all down here. It's kind of crazy, really. But lots and lots of nether bits. Should be able to do quite a bit now. I don't know what this plutonium is, but that can probably go in here as well. But yeah, been quite an eventful little trip there. So I think what I wasn't going to, but I think what I'll probably do is basically start making some RF machines and stuff like that down here, and start all doubling and things that. Right, well, still need a few more bits, but for the moment we can just stick these down. So I made a leadstone energy cell. That's a pretty easy recipe. Obviously, you probably saw me craft it there, so it's just a block of redstone, lead and stuff, copper to make that. So I've popped that down there. I might dig out underneath it. I've made some leadstone flux ducting, so that can run all the power along here. Might as well place all of that stuff down, keep it out of my inventory. I seem to have got stacks in my inventory. I've made a pulverizer, so that's, that could probably go there. So at least we can start pushing up some of those. Basically, you get more results out of them. I was going to try and build the furnace as well, but I need a bit more clay, so we'll come back for that. I'm going to swipe the engine from upstairs. It's currently charging the Apple milk and tea sort of charging station, and get it to charge this leadstone energy cell. I'm getting a little bit low on charcoal, so I'll probably go and chop some trees. Anyway, back in another second. Oh, and to cap it all off, we got another one of these guys around here. So, without further ado, I think he's about to die. Just a regular Isaac for the moment, so that's kind of handy. Let's stick a defensive wall there. Stick another one there. He just split into something else. What's he? He's a blood Isaac. Okay. Well, Mr. Blood Isaac, can we hit him from there? We can. Even funnier. Oops. Blimey. These guys are tough. I wonder if I could hit him underneath another rock. Apparently not. Got his body, and he got us again. Good grief. It's just another disembodied head again. Oh, I forgot there was a block just there. Anyway, this isn't going too well. Well, at least I can get my grave a bit easier this time. No. See if I can stick a bit more cobble up top. Wow, he's just there. Okay. Let's get rid of these death markers. These guys are tough. Come on, I should be able to hit them from there. Did he die? He died. Blimey. Bane of the Blood Isaac, I think, is probably going to be the name of this episode. They are tough, and I still haven't gone and got my clay. Anyway, let's eat some of this. And, get back to finding clay. A clam in sand. Okay, I don't know what this is. Can we dig it? We can dig it. What did I get from that? Sand. What about a clam then? Oh, what was that? We stopped drowning. Did we get it? Yeah, we did. There we go. Two clams. Okay. Clam dust. I'd rather have clam chowder, but okay. Very interesting. So, incense cone of growth. Okay. Yeah, part of this apple milk and tea, you can put down incense burners, so obviously you want that burner. Near some plants, I'm guessing, but let's get these clams at least. I think we're running out of clay here. I've been all the way down this end of the river, so I'll wander down the other end, but that could be a problem. Although, actually, I think now we might be able to make the clay conia, or whatever the plant from Britannia is. So that'll help get some. In fact, yeah, I think I'm going to do that. Because I've been all the way up this river. And that end's just there. I can't see any. Might be one piece here. Yep, this is all gravel. So, clayconia, here we come. So, the clayconia is a simple flower. In essence, all it does is moisten nearby sand, turning it into clay. Okay, well, we've got plenty of sand, so that's not a problem. So, wow, it looks like there's going to need a rune of the earth. Don't know if we had one spare. We did make three of them. We do, so that's really cool. So this guy looks pretty handy. Just a few petals there. I think we can handle this. Let's put one together. Okay, well, I've never thrown a rune of earth in one of these things before. So... this recipe's changed since I last used it, so let's see what happens. And there we go. One clayconia. So, this is going to obviously turn sand into clay. So, let's plonk it down there. Oops, there we go. All that clay. Whoops, let's not plonk him down there. All that clay just, all that sand just turned to clay up here. So let's just put all this away. I thought it might need a mana pool to operate, but obviously not. So let's just dig some of this away. Including this quicksand. I don't think it'll work with quicksand. We can try it in a second. I don't know if this works or not. Let's try quicksand. It may work, you never know. Nope, okay, well, let's just do some clay then. Fantastic, loads of clay. And there we go. Nice big stack. Now, I think it does need to be near your mana pool, and I think it does drain power from that. Let me just check that in a second. Okay, so we're well away from the mana pool up here. Let's... try some sand around this. Yeah, it's not drawing. So it does draw power from your pool. So, for future reference. Anyway, very very handy little plant that. Britannia, like I say, is some incredibly useful little plants and stuff. Let's pop him back in there for now, and I can carry on with my build and finally build my furnace. And there we go, one redstone furnace. Okay, so we can do all of our ore doubling down here now as well. Might just stick a chest on the end here. Okay, and these guys are finally charging, so good, we can bring our nether ore down and double them up a bit. Alright, let's get pulverizing. I've just turned off, just right click on this central one here to turn it off. You can obviously left and right click to turn output and stuff like that, but hopefully we'll get some extra stuff out of this, sulfur and things, so but, this thing really needs to charge up. Survivalist generator isn't the best, it's kind of basic, so anyway, that was a little bit of excitement for today, a little bit of Britannia, so probably call it a day there. Take care.